Hello everyone, this is Paranoid DJ. Yes, I am actually speaking on a video for a change, and I thought I'd do something a bit different than just the usual posting up a song accompanied with a picture this time. First off, I do just want to say that I'm really sorry for not being able to complete requests that have been a long time outstanding. I've had a busy few months, and a lot of other reasons I won't bore you with, and I haven't really had as much time to create stuff as I would have liked. But I will get them done eventually. I always finish my requests, it's just taking longer than I anticipated, so I appreciate the patience if you're still bothered about those, and I will get around to doing all the new ones I've received very, very soon. So in effort to make up for that, this little video is going to give you an insight into how I would approach doing a mashup. Now, for those of you who don't know what a mashup is, it's essentially taking the vocal of one song and then mixing it with the instrumental of another. There's been some quite noticeable ones over the years. You can do it with a lot of songs, like Gautier's Somebody That I Used To Know. Someone mashed that up with the instrumental of Beyoncé's Sweet Dreams. I think that's the name of the song, I don't know. But you can basically do it with any song, as long as you have the vocal and the instrumental on the same pitch. You might have to mess around with it a little bit. There was quite an infamous one a while back that mixed up Take That and Eric Pritz's Piano. And Piano, as you've known from the mashup preview that I put up on my channel many, many, many months ago, it's a good track to actually try mashup vocals with because it's got quite a decent chord sequence, and it's easily adjustable and you can time stretch the pitch without affecting the overall sound too much. I don't know what it is, I don't know whether it's just down to top quality production from Mr. Pritz, but yeah, that's the song we're going to be using as our instrumental track. Okay, the first thing we want to do is to make sure that this is in time with our tempo. Now, I already have the tempo set at 126 BPM, which is pretty much what Piano is. If you look throughout here, you see all the kick drums start at the beginning of the bars. There's no real times where it goes out of sync. If I zoom in just a little bit, yeah, you can see this kick drum is right on the beginning of the bar. Now, in order to reach that conclusion, that speed even, the best thing I usually recommend doing is just exporting a bar of the song you want to find the tempo of, especially with a dance track like this, and then letting FL analyze that. So what you need to do, you need to go into Edison, highlight a single bar, try and be as precise as possible, so like from the very beginning the waveform starts, four kicks, and then to the very beginning where the fifth kick would start. So then that's a full bar. So if you mute this full track and just loop this, so that's a full bar of music. Now, you also need to have an idea of what sort of BPM the genre ranges in. For example, house music like this tends to vary between 124 to 130 BPM at maximum. Trance is usually 135 to 145. Hard dance is between 145 and about 160, and then it's hardcore and all the other tougher genres than that. Now, because this is a house track, we know the range is somewhere between 124 and 130. So if you press this, the little waveform icon here, and you press the detect tempo option, you've got a range of BPM ranges to pick from. So we know that it's between 124 to 130. 100 to 200 is a bit too much of a big range, so we'll pick 75 to 150. And FL has detected the speed of the track at 125.842. So you press yes, and then automatically adjust the tempo. And if we see here, that bar is now perfectly in sync with an actual bar in our playlist. So we now know for a fact that the tempo of the original track is 125.842. The same thing would apply for when you're working out a vocal. For example, I have two vocals here along with their respective original songs. Both Lady Gaga Acapellas. We've got Electric Chapel here, and we have the Marry the Night. I'm going to use both of them in this mashup as an example to show how you mess around with it. Now, vocals are more difficult to find the actual tempo of because FL doesn't have like a solid drum beat to work with in finding out the space between each beat. So for these, you need to take the original track and loop a bar of this. So at the beginning, or near the beginning of the first verse of Electric Chapel, the kick drum comes in. So for the same process as piano, we highlight a bar. Again, try and make it as precise as possible. It's about there. If we move to the beginning, it's about here. Always, you need to look out for noticeable peaks in the waveform. So like, if it's dead flat like this, then you know that's the beginning of a certain sound. Now, judging from this alone, you can see that this Electric Chapel is obviously faster than 125.842 because it's not in sync with this bar completely. But it's not so much of a major difference, so I'll be using the same tempo range as before. Now, because I've already run this through FL, I know that this particular sample is 127.923. Sometimes FL can guess what the tempo is without the need to actually do a scan. If it is, it's most likely right, but if it doesn't match up with this bar technique, you're best doing the scan anyway, just to be safe. So we know that this is the speed of Electric Chapel, 127.923. So if we apply that same information to the acapella, 127.923, I hope that's right, and we press accept. Now FL knows that the speed of this acapella is the speed of this original, which means that when we put it in along with piano, then if we simply press fit to tempo, FL can accurately stretch this to fit the speed of piano. So that's what we're going to do for this opening section. Again, with the start of your vocals and any sort of thing you want to do in this, and always try and be as precise as possible. So from here, and there's a little bit of delay on this acapella, so we'll just leave that tail, and we'll slot it in here. Move to a section that actually has a melody. So we know that Gaga's voice starts on the first beat of the bar, so that's where we'll start the vocal. But judging from a few of these things, you can tell it's not perfectly in sync. So you press the fit to tempo option. And because FL knows the information speed already, it's able to stretch it out a little bit, slow it down so it matches piano speed. So we'll just move it back a little bit so it fits in better. So just a little bit of a tweak there. And sometimes you will have to mess around with the beginning of the acapella just to make sure it syncs, but as I said, this is what we have so far, and even if it's not in the same key, you'll be able to tell that they are in sync with one another now. So we now know that they're in time with each other, but as you may have been able to tell, they're not in the same key, so it sounds a bit off. Now, Gaga's singing in a key that's higher than piano's, so you can either lower her voice, which will make it sound unnatural because then it'll be pitched downwards, which is something I wouldn't recommend, or we can pitch up the instrumental. Now, again, if you have a musical ear, this will be a lot easier to determine, and it's a lot of basically experimenting. But I'm going to guess that we need to shift up piano by 200. So if we just let that work for a moment, and then we'll be able to test it out, and then choose a time stretching option here, so it doesn't sound as, well, time stretched. Okay, so now piano should be in the right key. Let's just double check it is. Now that's worked better than I hoped, because I didn't originally assume these would go together. Again, mashing up is mainly a luck of trial and error. You basically see what keys the two things are in, look it up if you really need the information, and then adjusting the pitch of the instrumental if possible to try and fit. Now with piano, as you can tell, it's been time stretched because the kicks aren't as strong as they could be, so you have a few options here. For this, I'm going to see what Pro Transient sounds like. It's just a different way of time stretching it. I'm not sure of the exact specifics because I don't know what the difference between one or the other is. I just know that the actual end sound is a lot different compared to what the auto time stretch would be. So now if you look, with that, the waveform changed so that the kicks seem to be back to their previous level of thud. So we'll try that again, see if it sounds any better. Yeah, I'll run through the process again, just with Marry the Night this time. Now, if I'm right, Marry the Night should be in the same key as this new piano is. But first we do need to find out the BPM of it. So again, the same technique will be used before. We have the original here. If we go to the beginning, mute this. Oops, wrong one. And we open up a section of Marry the Night where the kick drum comes in. Most likely here, because it just seems like it'll be easy to work with. There. As before, you be as precise as possible. And then we put it in. Now again, as with Electric Chapel, this is faster than the BPM we have set, but we know it can't be too much of a major difference considering the discrepancy between the end of the bar and the beginning of the next one is slight. So we press detect tempo. Again, in this instance, FL has detected the sample at being 130.844. And that's because we've given it a clean sample to work with. If something like this doesn't come up, then you do need to press the scan button, but in this instance, we don't need to again. So hang on, let me just double check that. 130.844. So we now know that is the speed of the acapella. 0.8, thank you. So now FL will be able to determine that the Marry the Night acapella needs to be slowed down by more of a percentage compared to Electric Chapel. So we'll move on to this next section where it comes in. Okay, so we've got the Marry the Night acapella here. Now because we already know the tempo, it will press fit to tempo. As you can see, that's stretched everything back so it's more in time. Now, this particular vocal doesn't fit completely in time with piano because Gaga says Marry the Night at least 3 times before the chorus comes in. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut those out, which we're going to use the slice tool for. And now this should be in time with piano. As I said, I think the keys are the same, so we don't need any modification to either of them. And we'll see what it sounds like. I'm a warrior queen, and passion in thee tonight. So just like with Electric Chapel, you might need to do a bit of jigging around because the tempo stretching may not have worked completely correctly, as we found out there, or my cutting wasn't precise enough, but the methods still stand. If you just turn the snap off here, and then you can easily just shift the vocal ever so slightly until it gets more in time. I also did need to turn on the volume there because there's a major volume difference between the verse lines and the chorus. So if we briefly put both vocals and run them through a compressor like this, then they should be at least a more similar volume. And then that's pretty much it. You're free to use the rest of the acapella in any way you want. You can chop up certain bits, you can add an extra delay effect, which I probably will do. And that's how I would approach a mashup. I hope it was useful to you all. I hope you enjoyed the actual idea of putting these songs together if you didn't think they'd fit before. And yeah, please continue watching if you want to see more songs. More will be coming soon, I promise. And I now leave you with Electric Piano.